Hey. Today we are talking about the automatic sealing bunker base for Rust Console Edition. That's right, it's just for us now. It was on PC a long time ago, but they have since patched it, so we have access to this, and it's super OP. You can use this today on wipe day. You can use this coming in late on a wipe. You can use this for solo, duo, trios, starter base, a flank base, or even farming bases. Build a couple of these bad boys. The basic footprint is roughly 2x2, but again, you can make many tweaks to this. We have cutaways all the way across here to show you how this mechanism works. That's what this video is about. We're focusing on that mechanism. But you can apply this many different ways. Please feel free to use this on Builder's Paradise to see how this is going to work for you. All right, so before we go through the main mechanism, we're going to walk you through, I'm going to give you like a light outline. So we're going to walk you through three of them. We're going to call this the door variant, the ramp variant, and then we'll have the window frame variant. We're going to show you how to do two of these, like do the build itself. But yeah, so it's super OP, man. Like, bunkers are great, but the downside is they're only great when they're sealed, and sometimes you get attacked when you're not there and you're online and you don't know that you needed to seal it. So this helps remedy that situation. So here's the first auto sealing bunker. So again, this can be your main airlock or this can be entering your core. If you're authorized, you just pass through here. Yes, you use the boxes to step through the window frame. And as long as you're authorized on the TC, that's what this is, the fridge is the TC, you're good to go. But if you're not authorized on the TC, let me just jump up here. If you look, there's a shotgun trap over the doorway. What that's going to do is shoot through the twig, and yes, it does shoot through the twig, and it's going to destroy the top of the staircase. And what this does is the procedural top of the staircase renders in, then obstructing the window frame itself, making it impassable. So, yes, people can shoot through there and raid, but this staircase blocks people from getting through and also soaks a lot more damage, so making it more difficult to raid in itself. And you can also stick a window in the socket here. Also, if you would like to then open this back up, just grab some blueprints, take a kneel, then just place some twig. Make sure your hammer's not out so you don't automatically upgrade this. And then you should be able to pass through the bunker, good to go. Pretty nice, right? Yeah, I know, it's the best. And again, you've got, this is a 2x2 and this area here needs to be 1.5 tall. So just to kind of keep you in, you know, the situation where you're like, oh, okay, that's how that works. So, yeah. And you don't necessarily even have to have a sleeping bag inside of here because all you really need to do is place the twig and then you can open up the bunker. Again, a big gotcha for this is definitely making sure that your hammer's not out. Just make sure there's a general rule that hammers are never out when you're walking through the airlock portion of the bunker base, the mechanism itself. Okay, so that's the rundown for this. We're going to give you kind of a breakdown of why this works. So right here you can see the procedural staircase does just that. When the cap is blown off like this, or the twig is, you can see that the wood completed the top here with the railing. And that's the way it's supposed to work, right? So, and then when you add twig, that procedural top, let me take a kneel. If you place this, the twig takes up that socket, so then it pushes that railing top to the top of the twig. And yes, you can do this with mixed types. So we have wood here and then twig. That's why this works. On PC, this doesn't anymore. It keeps the railing on the wood section, basically making everything blocked. But I don't think this is going to be patched out anytime soon, so you definitely want to use it. Okay, so in order for this one to work, we're calling this the door bunker base. If we step up here, let me show you. Actually, no. Okay, this might be best to do it this way. So when you're placing these staircases, spiral staircase, not the triangle spiral staircase, if you kind of look down, you can see if we have a direction, we have top, left, right, and then bottom, right? So if you see the blue outline right now, it is technically facing the right-hand side or the right-hand socket of the square that we're on. So that's important to know. So if you look at that, since it's taking up the right-hand socket, you can kind of tell like where that procedural top's going to go. Now, if I rotate it one more time, the flush side is now facing down towards me. And then if we do it this way, now the main side of this is facing off to the left. And if we do it one more time, now it's facing the top. It's important because when we're setting this up, let me see if I can jump over here. When you have these different doorways, you need to make sure that the portion that this socket's going to take up is like in the right position. So if I wanted on this doorway, this would be the right socket. You can see that the blue is mostly taking up the top portion of the square. Anyways, just keep that in mind. All right, so let's go ahead and do this build over here right quick. just important to see the different layouts so you know how it goes, because when you're placing the staircase, it's like, it's just, it's goofy because when you look at it, you're like, oh, is this where the top's going to be? But it actually goes one out. See what I mean? Like, that extra cap doesn't necessarily render in when you're looking at the frame. So if you're kind of stepping back, you can see it. Anyways, all right, let's do this on this side. I'm stuck under the ramp. Okay, here we go. Here we go. All right, so this is going to be the main entrance. And it's weird because there is a bit of a glitch with this where you should be able to place this anytime, anywhere, and then the render cap works. But there's like this weird socket glitch where, like, if there's some kind of deployable in the way, it will obstruct it. And it's not the way, it's not the behavior that has ever happened on PC, and it's a glitch for us. So even if they do patch that, this should still work. Now, as soon as they patch the procedural tops of these staircases, then you know this thing's broken. So basically, if you place another top on here, and like, let's say this is wood, and that's twig, if you see the wooden railing sticking through this twig, then you know this isn't going to work anymore. So it's going to be a while before we get that patched. So just putting that out there. All right, so again, this fridge is going to be our surrogate tool cupboard, as we're on a giant area here. So I'm hoping this all like works out for you guys, and it makes sense, because I believe the server is going to wipe relatively soon. So this is going to be a little tricky. Okay. So this is going to be the main entrance for the mechanism here. And if we can kind of put... Can I put this? Oh, perfect. And I don't have admin. Man, I wish we had custom servers. This would make it so much easier. I know everybody in the comments are going to be like, I want custom servers. I'm like, I do too. So if we're standing here... All right, good. We can actually get up on this railing. All right, so let me put this window frame here. So you want to make sure the hard side's facing you. It's important to set these things up first because this staircase is so fickle. So when you select the spiral staircase here, we need to make sure that it's going to block the window, because that's going to be the portion that actually gets blocked. So if you look here, you can see that the main part of the socket's facing down towards me, and the procedural top, the procedural railing, should go towards the window frame. If I do this right. Oh, thank goodness. Okay, so if you look over here, that's the way it's supposed to be. Perfect. Do we have a way to jump out of here? We don't. All right, let's put this down in the corner. It's a bit different when you can't just pass through walls and fly. All right, so we got to jump over here. So that does work. So here's the kicker. If this door's on the frame, it won't place again. Yeah, so it's goofy. So the first thing you want to do is make sure that you have this upgraded to something, stone, if you can't afford anything else. Go ahead and stick your door down, put the lock on, and because it's elevated so slightly, ever so slightly, you can make this jump, but to make your life easier and keep your sanity, I like to put a small box there, and then that way you can kind of just bloop, bloop. So once you have this inside of here, you do need to make sure that you have your half walls up. We'll keep a partial, and then we'll cap it off completely. I just want you guys to be able to see this. And then this would actually be flipped, and then this would be soft side facing you. Actually, we might as well just cap it now, right? It's kind of nice, because you have 1.5, you can kind of work in some interesting elevation changes, maybe even some furnaces if you need to, and the floor plan. So again, you can add this to many different base designs. Don't feel limited by this. You know what? We're going to have to break off the back here so we can walk in. Because I can't fly through the map. All right, hang on. Let me just break this one. Yeah, because it's going to get a little hairy in here. Okay, so let's just double check to make sure the mechanism does work. So if we take a kneel, perfect. And again, for your sanity, I would strongly recommend sticking a box here and also another box on the opposite side. And I like to stick the blueprints in there and a little bit of wood. But again, the biggest thing you need to do, you and your teammates, you need to make sure you have a no hammer out when you're passing through the airlock, because somebody's going to lock it by accident and you're going to be super sad panda about it. So just make sure that you're not walking through with the hammer. I'm telling you, as much as you think you're not going to do it, one guy's going to do it and you're going to lose your mind. All right, so right here you can stick the shotgun trap. I think we can still cap it. We should be able to, or otherwise we can make it slanted. Yep, okay, so we're definitely going to have to do that. You can do this. I know you can do this. We've done this on an active wipe. Line of sight block. Okay, I was going to say. It's kind of good it's daylight now. And a lot of... Yep, see, there you go. You can fit it right. You can even have it angle a little bit, so if you kind of use your alt look or step back a little, it kind of angles it. Either way, you're going to... This will still go up. Even if it doesn't hit somebody directly, it's going to hit the twig, and that's the point. And then, boom, this is going to close automatically. So let's go ahead and open this door real fast. So if you step through and you're not authorized, this is going to break, and it's going to seal that other side. Boom, you're good to go. Let's walk around the back here, and then, yes, you can still seal this up with a window frame. I'm sorry, a window. So you're good to go. So either way, as people break in through the doors or anything, these are always going to break and making this extra difficult to raid. So, and then you would upgrade like this to metal. And then everything on your interior here would be metal if you had the armored window. So you can start to see how this would be implemented. Oops, we got to make sure we rotate that bad boy. So this is the door variant. The one with the ramp is interesting because it's a little different, but also the way you reset it is different as well. So there you go. This is the door variant. Hopefully that all makes sense. I'm feeling a little rushed now that we've got this clock. All right, so here's the ramp version of the auto sealing bunker. Now, yes, you'd have to make some sort of airlock here to make sure that you don't just have a ramp sitting outside, although I guess you could if you wanted to. Actually, here, let me bring this back down. Let me take off this door. And this is a great example of why this one's so weird. You can't actually place... And this is not supposed to be like this. This is a bug. You're not supposed to be able to, like... Or you're supposed to be able to place it right here. And then the only way you can place, even if the door is coming out towards you, the only way you can place is if the door is off of the socket. And then you gotta crouch. Will it let me do it on the ramp? I think you have to be on the inside. Yep, see what I mean? Yeah, it's definitely not the behavior you want. So the ramp version's cute, but, like, I don't know. I don't like this one as much. Is you can see the locking mechanism is towards the door, and yes, you need the ramp, because if you didn't, then you could just crouch under the door. But if you have it back here, so if you spawn inside of the base back here, you can set up the spiral staircase and see how I kneeled and then it placed. So yeah, the ramp one's just, this is more to just show you that this is possible, but this one is definitely a lot trickier, and you need to take the door off each time, and you need to make sure you've got a sleeping bag on the interior, because if you don't, you can lock yourself out. But it still works. It still definitely works. And this does make it headier in the front here. So if you look at this ramp and stuff, it definitely makes it a lot beefier. It's going to soak a lot more damage. So just know that this is a variant. I'll stand up here so you guys can take a gander and see what I'm talking about. I know, right? That's why we're not going to build this one, because you're like, well, you can do it this way. But you can also see how, like, the locking mechanism is on the door. So in order for this to work, you need to have this ramp here. And it just makes it goofy. So yeah, ramp variant. And then if you walk through, the shotgun trap goes off, breaking the twig, locking up at the doorway instead of here at the window frame. But you need to make sure you have a ramp here, as somebody will just be able to walk under this. And the way to reset this is to take this off of the hinge here, take the door out of the socket, like so, and then make sure you respawn on the interior and then place your twig again to reset your entrance. And this is an auto-closing ramp variant of this. And if you see here, if you spawn inside of your bag, then you can place the spiral staircase, take a kneel, and then go ahead and place the twig, and you can see that the procedural top did render back in. And the shotgun trap's good right there. It'll just keep wrecking people as they come through. So you can use it like that. You can use it as a trap base. It's got many different implications. So here's the last one. I call this one the window frame. And this one's the easiest because it's not as fickle as the other ones with our current state. So this is the window frame variant of the same. So right here, again, you've got the window frame here with the twig on top, keeping the procedural staircase at bay. And then as somebody passes through that's not authorized, the shotgun trap will blow off the twig right here, rendering in the procedural metal staircase on the window, making it impassable. This one works consistently with our current version in March 2023 because we left all the major things out of the socket. So this back area of the staircase, you don't have to worry about resetting it because we just moved the door back to a triangle door frame and you're good to go. So to reset this, you can spawn on the outside. That's why this one's nice. With twig, take a kneel, you can place right there to enter back in. You can also spawn on the interior and just you don't have to worry about anything. You can just place this bad boy and you're good. And so as long as you keep it off this back socket until they fix that glitch, you're good to go. This one's a lot easier to deal with. So really, the only thing you need for this one is really a shotgun trap. And now with Tech Tree, it's easy enough to get. Okay, so let's go ahead and build the window variants of the auto-closing bunker. This is going to be where the tool cupboard is. Oh my goodness, why did I do that? So hopefully this all makes sense. We might end up doing this again later on because I feel so rushed because this is literally going to like wipe in like 15 minutes maybe. I don't know exactly when this is supposed to wipe. So I just bear with me. All right, so that's going to be your main TC area. Again, you can change this any way you want. The big takeaways here are you need a window frame here. You need nothing on this socket, and then some type of doorway. This doesn't even have to be a regular doorway. It can be a wall frame if you want it to be. We'll just make these stone real fast. You can see how you can use these in different areas. So hopefully that me explaining these different mechanisms, you're like, oh, okay, I can use this on my base if I wanted to. Because sometimes you don't have the elevation change to do like a stability bunker, you know? And this is just, it gives you more options. And as a solo, or even starting off solo, it just makes things much easier, I think. We have something here. Can I just put this right here so we can make the jump? Man, not being able to fly through walls like as an admin, that's rough, dude. Okay, so I just want to stand up here so you guys can see how the staircase is supposed to fit. Now, remember the way we're placing the staircases? The blue, so if you're to look at the square we have it sat on right now, so we have top, left, right, and then bottom. So you want the main part of the staircase facing the bottom, like so, and then you can see that the railing part renders in, obstructing the window frame, making this exactly what we want. Let me go ahead and make one of these just real fast so I can get back in quickly. Thank goodness for auto crafting. Who's excited for custom service though? Like real talk? But I am. So then right here you do the same, just stick your half walls on top. And then you can place your shotgun trap directly on top here. And then make this usually metal is what you want to make it. And then you can just stick your top lid on. And then we can go right to the shotgun trap, which apparently I did not craft. Oh, we used them all. Oh, the last one broke. That's right. Now, it's usually good to place the twig first and then go with the shotgun trap. It just makes it a bit easier. And then what I like to do here as well, this is just, again, for your sanity. These little small boxes make it nice to not only put the window frame and a little bit of metal and your construction paper, what is this called? Building plans. It just makes it easier to pass through so you're not always fighting the jump. Because I don't know about you, when I'm under pressure, I can't make jumps to save my life. So then right here you can place some doors, you're good to go. And again, if somebody comes through this window, that shotgun trap's going to wreck them, but it's also going to seal the bunker, making this another auto-sealing bunker base. There you go. Hopefully this helps out. Be sure to drop a like and subscribe. Check out the end screen there as we have some more juicy videos for you. And hopefully we'll see you in the next live stream/video. Love your bush. Bye.